correct me, Brent Jackson, back again with round, I believe, 12 of the Formula One Plus Championship Season 4. This time we're going to head off to Spa. But before that, I do want to touch on a few things that have happened. Jaguar still winning the Constructors' Championship, just barely though. It's about a good 14 points in it. Blake Benson winning the championship by 8. That's a race win, by the way. And also, I do want to touch on this. Last season, the season before, at this point of the championship, 12 points again, there were more points given out to the world championship leader. There were more points there. But now, there's only 129. One, that's down to the amount of wrecks we have, especially in the past few races. And two, and that's because, well, race wins aren't being the thing that's being awarded. Three drivers, have won twice this season. Brave Dragon Sonic, Tom O'Connor, Ryan Fabinus. And yet, Brave Dragon Sonic, the one who's winning the championship, because of his consistency. But where was I going with this again? Oh, that's right, the championship. So let's hit the Spa for the Spa New Brain in Belgium. The driver there here, Blake Jensen on the pole, waving one result in second, and he's Cactus in third, and Abel in fourth. Think of the Miles Stern, not Lewis Hamilton, Anna Bannis, and Waver. Then Mohamed Awali and his teammate, Medesis. Then the two Audi, the Fantastic, and the Tuco. Then Bird, O'Connor, Sierra, and Dennis. Then comes Salazar, and then Aldridge, Marcus Nelson, Polar, Karen Chandok, and Dirk Rosicus. So, Brave Red Sword and Polar with the two Jaguars right behind him. All five lanes going down. We go green, spot from the Deschamps, and that's a very good start from Ronnie Sullivan. Honestly, they can go the jump on Blade Drake Sonic. He's going to try and go around the outside, coming out of turn one. Not quite there to make a move. Step back, Sarah Sonic. I think it's happening. I'll see the calling collision in the low midfield there. But out in front, Catfish is still looking at the back of his own teammate, Ronnie Sullivan, who's trying to take the lead away from that Mercedes. Oh, Blade Drake Sonic, he's looking as if he's going to try and get the inside line. Coming down into turn four. And he swung way too wide. He's pushed a teammate off as well. What a fast overtake there. And Luke Hamilton making the most of that opportunity to get himself up to third place momentarily. And now he's under threat from the other Mercedes driver of Miles Stone. Ray has actually had a great start there, up into sixth place he's been. It's been an awful start for the Tuco though. He's gone down to 15th. But anyway, as always, the soft tyres are the perfect start tyre, the mediums are the race tyre, and the hard tyres are the tyres you need if there are multiple pit stops happening. Because you won't need to. This is the shortest lap count on the calendar, and that's because of the amount of turns that there are. But down to the bus stop chicane then. New Cable hopping over the curb at the exit, everyone seemingly doing that just because it's the faster way to get through the turn. You do get a bit airborne going over that bump there. Ronnie Solo looking as if he's going to get DRS, going up through Radion. He might get DRS here. Is DRS active on this lap? I believe it is. Yes, it is. Still down the Cable Street, easy overtake for him. If he can just make it the right place, Ronnie Sullivan is taking his fastest first up there and taking the lead. But this Spar E3 on pure pace alone for the first time in quite a while. Tom O'Connor down at 15th place though, on board in the fight in the 26th, coming down into the turn of their game. And yeah, this midfield fight, this really be great to see happen, but finally we have that up front a lot more
instead of accepting the two drivers, everyone's like, yeah, this is the country won the championship or something. Come on, when we saw the thing was going to the front, the road gets like, coming through Blanchard now, up into the last stop chicane. Scarf inside, man, the road gets off, they're very close to there. Oh, it's a switchback attempt from the Mercedes driver, Carlos, and he crossed up in E3 as if he wants to join the spot of the lead of E3. It might not be 3-1 coming down to the Cannon Street. The Jesus is going to try to get his one over there. Coming through a roof there. Up the hill, onto the Cannon Street then. Stefan Sarandon with a track on the line already on top. This 5-second time penalty as Blake McIntyre takes the lead of the E3. Ronnie Sola getting another track on this morning. One of them was for defense and now just trying to defend from his own streamer. This is hectic as two wide go the Jaguars into the toe in their own lane. Does Catfish get ahead of his own teammate here? There's still a sign on the side of teams. He's been running so much, just staying ahead. And he is getting all the way down the line. They're dropping off his own teammate. Great stuff to see. Mark 4 of 15. Well, let's go down inside. Goes Rockzilla. And he's got another track on it. Ballot of Morning. They're going side by side. The 4 is now. Blake Rockzilla is going to get the DRS on this lap. All the way to the river. So maybe that's all the other thing at the source. There's a bit of a receipt. At the Cannon Street we are now. And that is probably the easiest thing that you've ever been in today. And that's 5 seconds out of the running, so it's time for track limits. That's a fourth violation. Wow. You might want to let teammate go here. Because that is going. Number 2 goes for 5 seconds for causing collision. And what's happened here? Is there a puncture for any of these drivers? Seems possible. But it does not seem to have happened. Does seem like these two have just had a bit of a coming together of Sierra and Batuco. But nothing too crazy. The drivers who have 5 second time penalties, they're all for cause and collision, apart from Ronnie Sola, who just like can't keep in between the right lines for some reason. 10 laps to go. Yeah, these laps don't exactly fly by. And UK Ball gets a track limits violation warning on this lap. As he swipes for first place, he's behind the swipe for the lead. On board with UK Ball, comes through a move, very close between the two of them. Just gonna hit him at the Catfish as Wayland getting ahead of Bart O'Stone. And meanwhile, up ahead of these two, Ronnie Sola sending it down the inside on Blake McIntyre, making the sack work. Up into the lead, he goes, but he's got a bunch of time. He gets very wide from Wayland, almost into the wall. Seems to be just Catfish coming out of those two turns there. Very hectic. Wayland got through these guys. Blake McIntyre takes the lead of the Wayland. We're not able to see that there. Those two are just kind of going at it, but we're looking at this four-way fight for third. Beautiful overtake. Maneuvers made everywhere they can. That's the most hectic affair you've ever seen. And I think, yeah, Ronnie Sola is taking the lead considerably at this point. Is there a potential puncture threat? Merchant for any of these drivers. I'm just checking through the lower place drivers. These guys will need to come to the pits pretty soon though. Wayward looking as if he could send it back inside Seymour with a dumping frozen time penalty. That's a trap running violation from Raybo. And by the way, you made that overtake. Something tells me that frozen time penalty was for causing a collision as into the pits comes Sam Bird. He's going to go up for the medium tires. Same with Jake Dennis. This is an intentional pit stop for those two. This is going to drop him far down the order. And Blaze up so we take the lead of E3. Robo up in the third place then. And Catfish trying to send him around the outside. He'd earn UK ball. There are some opportunities in motor racing where you just have to look and stand to send it. I don't think Catfish is going to get it. Sanchez for the track run. Morning. Rocky Solo. Now for F's sake, he said. For that track run this morning, but 5 second time penalty. Sarazan with another track limits violation warning. He's presented by the 16th with his teammate Alfridge. You are just kind of going at it at this point. And it does look to be a bit overcast right now. Will we get rain? We've just been told that 5 second time penalty was track limits. As into the pits comes UK Ball. And he's going off to the medium tyres. Now, I'm not a meteorologist or anything. I think it might rain. Many drivers are coming into the pit at this point as well. So I'm not too sure. If it's going to rain or anything. But Ronnie Solo was right on the back of Blaze Red Clutch with the tyre as he now retakes the lead of the E3. And with these going on 47%. The tyre wear as Jake Dennis causes a collision, giving himself a 5 second time penalty for causing said collision. I can't believe still how the collision could have happened. Aldridge being trapped on his violation warning. And these worn out tyres causing many a driver some issues. Badness is actually like way off the back of Catfish right now. It's kind of shocking to see this kind of stuff happen. In a race, like Ryan's is 7 laps in, already a minute down, but if there was ever a track to it, it was far. On board with Ryan Stone then, in the 95, is Ryan a whirlwind! And he's got a 5 second time penalty for causing a collision. And who's that with? I can't tell. I cannot tell who that tackles is, and down inside! It on Raybo goes Milestone as Blaze Red Sonic only pits on this lap. Is Rodney Solo in? No, he stayed out. So onto the medium tires goes Blaze Red Sonic. He's going to drop down quite a bit down the order. Probably around 5th is where he's going to come out, maybe. I'd say 5th is a safe bet. He comes out just in 4th. Just ahead of his old teammate. No, not his old teammate. I thought that was waiting for a second now. He's about 2 seconds down. UK Ball's going to get the eye from Blaze Red Sonic here. Coming up for Rouge and Radioff. Onto the camel straight we go. Who's going to come out ahead coming into the chicane? It's of course going to be UK Ball. The man with the DRS. Of course he's going to take the lead. Stefan Sarazan is coming into the pit on the slap as well. It doesn't look like anything too serious is happening in this race. He's at this point. Your cable does seem to be slowing down just a little bit as Blaze Red Sonic has gone past him. Just seemed a bit old for him at least. Blaze Red Sonic, he sets past the second sector of any driver in this E3. Ronnie Solo and Miles Stone, they've gone very long on their soft tyres. We're about to see if it paid off. They're both coming into a bit at the end of this lap. And at Cavendish, he's gone very long on his mediums. Does he come in on this lap? No, he stays out. So, the man we have to look at is this. Blaze Red Sonic, he was the first man to pit out of the top guys. Badness leads. Bladed Dragon Sonic second. UK Ball third. UK Ball second actually is Ronnie Silver. Always has a tangle with his own teammate and Rainbow. Having a while we're doing a track run that's violating warning. You have six penalties handed out on half of them. And that worth the reasons you can't get a penalty. Meanwhile, further up the order. Great Dragon Sonic, he's made his way past UK Ball and hopefully this time he can hold the position. But Ronnie Solo, he's had his balls kicked in at this point. By not just his championship rival, but by his teammates. Some teamwork this is. Maybe they're going to try and do something where they get caught strikers together and then have the DRX thing happen that we saw in Singapore in real life. This looks a bit hectic. As UK Ball, he's got my blade on time. And now he looks to try and get upon Ida Batman, the man who took his seat. He gets ahead of him. Same with Blade Dragon Sonic after he takes over ahead as he comes into the boss stop chicane. Bamis coming into the bits on the slap. Kind of looks like he's going to be forced into the wall there. But UK Ball leads. And that's one case he's on the car Blade Dragon Sonic here. And Revolution Racing with a superior strategy with 5 laps to go. I'll leave it. A 1-3. But look at this, Blade Dragon Sonic is about 2 tenths of a second down. No, 1 tenth of a second down. He's looking to be side by side. And by the time we make it into the chicane, Blade Dragon Sonic leads the sparring free once more. Catfish running himself up to fourth place. Yes, and we do have that 5-way fight for the lead. And not for this Hamilton gets himself a 5-second tag on the seat for causing a collision with Matt Nawawi. A lot of these penalties are coming from really clutzy driving. The kind we see at Mexico. But without that unfortunate second of track as Miles Stone has a 5-second tag on the seat adding to the end of his race time. The only drivers in the top 10 who don't have penalties currently are Blade Dragon Sonic, who's leading by 4 seconds, and Catfish, who's ahead of UK Ball by 3 seconds. His own teammate is coming at him. What? I don't even know how to say it. Raven's up into third place then. And then you've got Mohamed Wally and Ina Bamis. Those are the guys who don't have a penalty. Everyone else in the top 10, they've got penalties. It's all even down to not being able to stay within the white lines of some really clutzy and rookie errors. I don't think we've had a single yellow flag this race, which is refreshing, to be honest. The last few races have been filled to the point where yellow flags, safety car periods, virtual safety car periods, just got a bit tiring after a while. It was cool the first time. Not anymore. Cameron Deason going up into 8th place ahead of his teammate. He's going to hit on his follow up, but he's got himself a rear puncture. I don't think anyone caught that. Unless he doesn't come out like that. Let's see if we can do something in that. It's basically an entire lap down this Colorado. It's pretty sad to be honest. But still, it's pretty overcast. Imagine if it starts raining on the final lap of the break. We saw something similar a few seasons ago. And that was probably the coolest race finish we've ever seen. Slap 12 and 15, then Blade Dragon Sonic leads with Catfish in 7th. UK Ball is going past his teammate again to get up to 3rd place. Then comes Rainbow, who the afternoon teammate. Then comes Miles Stone, Ronnie Solo, and not Lewis Hamilton. Rainbow, Stone, Solo, and Hamilton have all got themselves penalties. Wait, how the hell do I even pronounce this guy's name? Is it not Hamilton? Hamilton? Not Lewis?
Yeah.
They're going four wide on the Kettle straight! Waver's got himself a track limits warning. That's his third and final warning. If he does it again, he's going to get a 10-second time penalty, which will be added onto his final race time. On board with Miles Stoneman. He's looking as if he can get past Stu Cable ahead. But Waver, in sixth place, is trying to send him down the inside on Ronnie Solo. And you know what? He's not going to do it. He's done it, though. He's just about managed to get up into fifth place as the Revolution Racing driver. The team that shares its name with its first driver, its most successful driver. And they're running third and fifth. That's without penalties in contention. And that's Felix Rosenquist. And he's going quite slowly. He's being lapped by all these drivers from the 25th on lap 13. And a 13th lap stint on those hard tyres is, there's no way to put it, it's just pretty impressive, to be honest. Oh, is anyone else trying to go that long? Yeah, Tony Khan. He's on the lead lap. He's got very long on those tyres. Sam Bird's coming into the pits. And this is a scheduled stop, so... And is this just trying to go just a little bit faster on his final stint on those softs? This is a bit from Stella Connor. He's going to go into the softs. Bird didn't actually lose any position. He only lost one to Jake Dennis, which isn't too bad. So he wasn't scoring any points. It doesn't look like he's going to be scoring any points at all. Down in 15th now. All he can hope is to take that first flat point away. On board with Ronnie Silver, trying to go around the outside of Miles Stone. He's trying to send it on the table as they're coming up on the lap car. Marcus Nelson in the number 13. Number 13 was the first car to win a championship. It's great that he's trying to run himself a track limits warning. That's lapping Kieran Shanda. Top line here as into the pit stands Hugh Cater. Is that enough of those mediums? Should have made it to the end on those mediums. He's just thrown away the podium. Is it looping into at this point? Is it like... So 5 seconds from the solo right now drops into sixth. But everyone behind him drops into sixth as well. So he stays in third. Rodney loses nothing. Into the victims, Jake Dennis. So penultimate lap of a spy three. Good boy, Ben Sonic should come to this on the spot, just as long as. Can he come into the mix at the end of this lap? If Esteban Ocon's ever going to go by then, yeah. Don't mind me just vibing. Ronnie Solo up in third place right now with Miles Stone behind him. Looking at the mini map. We're on to the final lap for V3, everyone. Blake Brent for the lead on lap 15. He's seen out for his final team. Same with Catfish and Ronnie Solo. Miles Stone trying to send it down inside. Coming into the source. Stone getting the track all in this violation, Ronnie. But you know what? He sent it on a season veteran. Solo getting back ahead. But that's at the DRS line. I think Stone's going to get DRS on board with the Mercedes EQ driver. And that's Shandok, who's suffering with worn tyres and a slow-ass car. Catfish then before his first lap to Venom. Stone, and Raven's gonna fight in the back of him. He needs to cause a collision. And that's with Shandok! Karim Shandok in the barriers! Here in Spine, last part of his front wing! And that's the yellow flag that everyone was clamouring for! Track's been cleared though, no real serious implications have come out of that, apart from a missing front wing for Karim Shandok. His teammate Paul Rock down in last place, he's just about to start his final lap on the E3 then. But coming up to the bus stop chicane, it's been a very easy going race. If you've got a safety car, Karim Shandok out of the E3, he's been spun round by Aldrich, it seems. No, but coming to the line at a very slow speed, it's a safety car just been called. Bladed Dragon Sonic wins the Spa E3. Catfish is second, and at the line, Ronnie Solo is third. Well, it's not at the line. Then comes his milestone, Raven, but let's see where he pops. Not the Hamilton, Ionic Ramness, the Desus, the Wowie, and UK Ball. Then will come Sanchez, Matuko, Sierra, Berg, O'Connor, Dennis, Charizard, Aldridge, Nelson, Rosenquist, and Polar. Well, what a anticlimactic way to end an E3. Solo would drop down the fifth, so he's going to keep his position. Stone will also keep his position. Rover's going to drop down to eighth place. Not Lewis Hamilton will also drop down to eighth place, which means and Trent is going to be 7th. Just for the game. I would also like to remind everyone, Polarop was 2 laps down just for that. 2. The downfall of the Philly team, it's a sad one. No, it wasn't. And this is your podium then. Catfish, second place again. Ronnie Solo, just about managing to hold on to third place. And Blading Dragon Sonic, it's another flawless weekend for him. It's Blading Dragon Sonic from Catfish and Ronnie Solo. Then comes Milestone, Ionet Badness, Kimmy Isis, Notless Hamilton, and Raver. Then comes UK Ball, Mohamed Nawawi, E. Sanchez, Matuko, Sierra, Bird, O'Connor, Dennis, Aldridge, Sarazan, Nelson, Rosenquist, Polarock, and your only returning is Karim Shandok. In the driver's standing, Blade Running Sonic leads on 154 points from Ronnie Solo on 136. Then comes Catfish on 107. Then the two Maserati drivers tied on 85 points apiece. Then comes UK Ball on 83. Mohamed and Wally on 80 points. Milestone on 78. Tom O'Connell on 76, Sam Bird on 50 points, Raver on 47, Medesis on 31, Matuko on 27, and Sierra on 24, Sanchez on 23, Dennis on 15, Rosenquist on 12, Polarock on 4, Aldridge on 3, Nelson on 1, Shandok and Sarazan still yet to score. In the constructors' standings, coming into the Munich E3, Jaguar still lead on 243 points. That's now only 11 points ahead of Mercedes-Benz. Then comes Maserati on 170 points. Then Revolution Racing on 130. Team McGuire's up next on 111 points. The rise of that team from going to bankrupt to now fit in the championship is astounding. Then comes McLaren Neon on 91 points. DS Virgin Racing on 74. Absolute Rally Sport on 50, Angel Racing on 13, Chili Grand Prix on 43, and Dragon Racing on 3 points. We'll see you next time for the Munich E3.